communication, particularly when you try to talk about our research findings with those who work in ministries or elsewhere, that we often push we need to be able to identify more of what natural science that might call tipping points in the ecosystem. In political research, we probably need to be able to be more specific about avenues that can be taken or not taken and what we think some of the results of that would be. And finally, I think that there's some work to be done. We are doing this, hopefully, if we get funding for this project from UFORCH, but it's also working with IT people and natural scientists to think about the format that the research comes in. We often focus on written formats, but what about, say, an accessible scenario facility where people could kind of somehow dial their way forward to give you a picture of what they think might happen in their community with some input.
Thank you, Elena. And I think you, Anatoly, would like to add something on it. And if you also could try to answer the last question, to point out some of the main succeed factors for what you project.
You mentioned the Bumblebee project, which is now going on, on the Antarctic Monitoring Assessment Program called Adaptation Action for Changing Arctic. It's a project which is conducted by many researchers in different countries, studying, having three case studies, and one of them is by so I'm involved in that. And this is exactly to inform not only politicians, but actually both broader community. The project will not stop with reports, but it will at least establish a system where these reports can be used and get the data. So I think this is an attempt to what you large count to involve not only politicians, but maybe communities. What do you think? And when it comes to Veronica, and I think most successful factors, I would say that this should be a cooperation because I don't think we could move any of this. So if we do this cooperation, then that's it.
Okay, thank you. And Mr. Sedmin, you were challenged by the chairman of the Barents Secretariat on the issue of Barents Cooperation.
Just reminded me about my favorite institution in the Arctic region because exactly for that reason that the Barents Euro-Arctic Council has two formats, one ministerial, one on the regional government something. And I have evolved along with other experts that the second format would be very important. And it seems that in the 90s that that kind of format was local and doable. And a number of provinces from Russia, from Finland, from Norway have established very good relationships. I remind you about Jun Karelin and Northern Kalot projects, cooperation between Svalbard, Norway, and the Murmansk region, especially my favorite, the Canadian project between Nikita and Chirkenes. But unfortunately, for many reasons, which actually I analyzed together with my call for European Union from Finland, that kind of projects they stopped or they suspended. And now it is sort of dead end. And I guess this is high time to resume them or revise them. As for the question about the list of successes or success stories in the Arctic operation, I can give you a lot of examples, ranging from search and rescue operation, REMIT 2011, REMIT on preparedness to fight in oil spills, 2013, recent documents adopted in the Italian Ministerial a session of the World Arctic Council. We also close to preparing or signing a number of other very important environmentally related documents. So I think that's regarding this Ukrainian crisis, other repercussions, we are moving forward. And I believe that the Arctic Council is such a success story. And perhaps your council as well.
Thank you very much, and maybe one last question before you get your books, and you have to answer it honestly, if you not, you will not get the book. I picked the question actually from your book, Anatoly, and the question is a very complicated one, but since you, Anatoly, have written it, and I am asking it, I will ask Elena and Sagunin to try to answer it very, what you write in your book is Will Russian-Western relations improve or worsen? And second, how will that affect the Russian-Russian relations? Are you prepared to give a remark on that?
Yeah, quite scientific, I would say. This is a big uncertainty to answer. We don't know.
Yeah.
This is how we... But I think that there is a dimension here which is broken. I think this is, adds extra value to the Russian relations. So it makes, let's say, situation on the cooperation between capitals can be worsened. But I think maybe regional cooperation will drive us forward. And the people we see, because we were doing it for many decades and centuries, for more trade. People have been selling things because there was economic opportunity, not because there were capital providing systems.
So, Lunin.
Yeah, I would be more positive and optimistic. I believe that we are doomed to success and cooperation.
Thank you all very much. I came directly from an interesting meeting in Tumen, Siberia, before I arrived here, and I learned, I haven't checked it, but the Russian troops that helped Norway during the Second World War, going into Finnmark, or Storskog, Kirkenes, they actually started and came from Tumen in Siberia. And that is a quite interesting fact, if that is that is true. So thank you very much to the panel, thank you to the audience, and you all deserve the book.